This is not a test. Test. This is live. Here we go. And yang. The robots are coming. The only way to stop them is $1,000 a month for every citizen. And the yang gang.
Potential dangers of big tech. Some of those dangers are imminent and they're technological, and the main one is robotics and artificial intelligence. Remarkably, the person, the political figure who is making the most sense on this subject, who has thought about it most deeply, is a Democrat who is running for president. He's Andrew Yang. He says that artificial intelligence and expanded automation could potentially cause violence in this country and that we need to do something about it right now. Andrew Yang joins us tonight. And I meant that with sincerity. I haven't heard anybody in our political conversation describe the threat as clearly and compellingly as you have. Why should we be worried about automation?
Well, if you look at the backdrop, we automated away 4 million manufacturing jobs in Michigan, Ohio, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, Missouri.
So universal basic income, this is what this is all about.
Yes, yeah, that's what my campaign for president is all about.
That's an interesting focus of a campaign, and very unusual. And I mean, 4 years ago, you never even thought that would have a chance at all. But this is a subject that has been gaining momentum, and I made a big shift because I had my friend Eddie Wong on once, and he was the first person.
Fucking robots are going to take over. And straight up, there's nothing we can do about it. Just telling them. But we get $1,000 a month. And if you hear this, John Connor, come fucking help us.
Of course, the crowning achievement of the platform, what everybody's talking about. I have a little bit of a whiteboard here to explain, you know, why should we support Andrew Yang? What is the real reason behind it? What is the biggest thing? To really, again, give you a visual demonstration, because I said at the outset, you know, why doesn't it matter that he supports all these terrible things, like, you know, Election Day being a federal holiday and Puerto Rico becoming a state and marijuana? I think this whiteboard is going to really give you an idea. I think it should really kind of say it all in a visual way, a very good sort of comparing and contrasting why it's so different, why it doesn't really matter, all those other things. And it's very simple here. I think everyone can wrap their heads around this. Everybody can understand this. Here's what makes him different. This is the thing that pushed him over the edge, for me at least, in my mind. Because, you know, we could go back and forth for hours and days about, oh, illegal immigration and Medicare for all. Will it work? Can we afford it? Will he secure the border? How's this amnesty going to work out? He wants to give everybody, I don't think you understand, he wants to give everybody $1,000 a month. He wants to give me $1,000 a month. He wants to give you $1,000 a month. He wants to give Beardly Beardson $1,000 a month. He wants to give Donald Trump $1,000 a month. Sean, Prince Hubris, Paul Town, PewDiePie. Well, no, PewDiePie's in the United Kingdom. He wants to give everybody in the country, no matter your income, anything else, $1,000 a month. And, you know, this started out as a joke, but it's actually totally serious. And I'll tell you why. A lot of people have taken this and they say, well, what do we really have to lose? Donald Trump has failed. We're going to get a Democrat or we're going to get Jared Kushner. So why not get gay marriage, open borders, abortion, and everything else, and also get $1,000 a month? And hey, will he be able to implement it? Well, it doesn't matter. If he does, you get $1,000 a month. If you don't, well, you'll get that anyway with anybody else. Are we able to afford it? Well, who cares? It's $1,000 a month. Oh, the debt will go up a little.
There is a Democrat by the name of Andrew Yang who is proposing universal basic income type thing. It's a universal basic income type thing. But apparently Andrew Yang has a meme problem because they say the memes being spread right now are sabotage. I have noticed there are a lot of people associated with a certain section of the right who are joining the Yang Gang. They mention in this article that 4chan is inundated with something called Yang Gang. I have no idea what it is because I'm not familiar with, you know, what they do on 4chan for the most part.
Random is shared sometimes, and so that I don't know if there's a case of brains being interconnected, but I wouldn't be surprised that it's theoretically possible. White Pill Pro sends $20. He says the biggest benefit is having a fallback when the corporations fire us for having the wrong beliefs. It allows us to take risk and give income to alternative voices. Yeah, I would agree, definitely. Free Helicopter Ride says bribery gang gang 1k bag bitch. People are extremely enthusiastic about this idea that the $1,000 would be coming in a bag, because Andrew Yang has this kind of gangster attitude on the social media. He says get the money and run. Dirty D disagrees, says
we just want it in ones too, so like you can just like
no! God, no!
No, like, it's fucking too much. Can you turn the fan right up?
He spent $50 and tipped 30% to get a bowl cut and the occasional brush of boobs against the back of his fucking neck. What are you talking about? The only people who cut my hair is my fucking wife. You hear me? The only people that cut my hair is my wife. And my mother sometimes.
Claiming that Andrew Yang is orchestrating a conspiracy to spread memes because he wants to win by using meme warfare. And then this article pops up, but they're claiming it's sabotage. What's really happening? I have no idea, but why would someone target Andrew Yang? Apparently he's polling less than 1%.
He says, here's how Yang can still get us our neat bucks. Love is a four-letter word, says, thoughts on Tim Pool's conspiracy theory on Yang's support from 4chan and Richard Spencer. Pool implied astroturfing and or sabotage. It's true, it's getting more and more discussed. This whole idea that the Yang phenomenon on the internet would be a conspiracy involving either the Russians, that's one version I've heard, I've heard the Jews, I've heard Israel, I've heard lots of conspiracy theories. Do you think it's an organic phenomenon?
I think it's absolutely organic. I've been involved in a lot of conspiracies that I knew nothing of. I you know, the Russians supporting the alt-right and all this kind of stuff. I've yet to receive payouts from Papa Putin, but is this Tim Pool? I don't know. I thought Tim Pool was actually pretty good on Twitter. I think he actually made things more complicated than he needed to. But I think that his appearance on Joe Rogan was pretty good. But generally speaking, Tim Pool he'll say these just really lukewarm, banal takes on the media and journalism and so on, and then he'll engage in some Alex Jones style conspiracy theory. He's kind of like the ultimate alt-lighter. He's kind of,
I was gonna have to make a conclusion as to where the memes were coming from. I'd have to say probably from him, because no one sees him as a threat, and this is getting him press coverage, and here I am following up the press coverage of the conversation about it. Admittedly, I don't know a lot about what this guy wants. I know that he's proposing what's something he calls like a freedom dividend, where you get $1,000 a month. Well, you've heard my opinion on that. If you,
it makes me think of Sargon of Akkad so much, very much Sargon's at the center. What?
Sargon's a lot smarter.
Sargon is smarter. I guess I would have to say you're right. Tim Pool is a kind of catalog of everything that happens. It's like he's a reporter, but in that sense, he's making his job. When he reports 3 or 4 times a day, and it's like there's the fact. He's not a profound thinker.
People are talking about Andrew Yang. I have seen on Twitter the Yang Gang, and I have been enjoying some of the memes. But I didn't really know much about Andrew Yang himself, so I thought I'd give him a look. And, I mean, to be honest with you, the impression I've come away from it with is positive, but not very optimistic. I mean, he seems like an absolutely jolly fellow, which is something I can definitely get behind. Just a candidate who seems to be happy to be doing what he's doing. I think that's great. He says, I'm a CEO and a business person, and I'll tell you that putting money into people's hands is good for business. It's good for the economy, it's good for markets. This is not socialism, this is capitalism where income doesn't start at zero. say, okay, that's true. I mean, I agree with him in principle what he's saying there. Putting people's money into people's hands, but leaving them with their money is good for business. The thing is, I mean, where are you getting these $1,000 for each person a month? I mean, I'm suggesting it might be through taxes, right? I mean, that's the only way I can see you raising that, unless you're going to go into massive debt.
So, you can just like.
Oh God, he's coming back!
There's a...
Get out of here!
And we have got to elect Hillary Clinton and Tim Kaine.
Every now and then I get a little bit lonely and you're never coming around.
So you say, hey, do I think I can be president of the United States? The threshold question is this. Can I get 40 to 50,000 Iowans on board with the idea that them and their family members getting $1,000 a month is a good idea? That would actually help improve their lives?
Well, I'm sure it would help. You're helping in a tremendous way by educating people. But I think most people have... It may be illogically, but they have different concerns. So how do you address these other concerns? Like, I bet if you polled people, what are the issues? What are the issues in this upcoming 2020 presidential race that, you know, who's going to beat Donald Trump? How do you do it? Yep. This is like on the Democratic side, the idea is like anyone but Trump, right?
Yeah.
This is, I mean, they would be so happy if fill in the blank.
Why should we be worried about automation?
Well, if you look at the backdrop, we automated away 4 million manufacturing jobs in Michigan, Ohio, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, Missouri, and those communities have never recovered. Where if you look at the numbers, half of the...
And a lot of that was just manufacturing work. And if you go to a factory, you'll see it's just giant robot arms as far as the eye can see. Mm-hmm. So it's not just that you have artificial intelligence on the horizon. It's that we've been eating away at the most common jobs in the U.S. economy for almost 20 years now. And it's just now hitting a point where it's pushing more and more unskilled men in particular out of the workforce.
When you're a kid, like, Howard Stern was the bomb. Like, he used to, everybody that's on the left right now, that's like an old boomer left or whatever, they all used to be like us. Like, they just changed. Like, they're like, fucking losers now. Well, like, I mean, like, that's like the mentality of, Howard Stern. It's like a Howard Stern, like, you know, used to have, like, anal ring toss on his show or whatever. Like,
that sounds fucking awesome.
So, like, Howard Stern actually used to do the show.
Who would not want to watch that?
I did watch it, like, multiple times. Because it's hilarious, too. Like,